Genesis chapter 19. And the two messengers came into Sodom at evening, when Lot was sitting in the gate of Sodom. And Lot saw, and he rose to greet them, and bowed with his face to the ground. Oh, please, my lord, turn aside to your servant's house, and bathe your feet, and you can rise early and set off on your way. And they said, no, we will spend the night in the square. And he pressed them hard, and they turned his way and came into his house. And he prepared them a feast and baked unleavened bread, and they did eat. They had not yet lain down when the townsmen, the men of Sodom, from lads to elders, every last man of them, gathered about the house. And they shouted to Lot and said to him, where are the two men who came to you tonight? Bring them out to us so that we may know them. And Lot went out to them at the entrance, closing the door behind him, and he said, please, my brothers, do no harm. I have two daughters who have known no man. Let me bring them out to you, and you can do to them however you please. Only to these men do no harm. For they have they not come under the shadow of my roof beam? And they said, step aside. And they said, this fellow came as a sojourner. Now he sets himself up to judge. Now we'll deal worse with you than with them. And they pressed hard against the person of Lot and pushed forward to break down the door. And the two men reached out their hands and pulled Lot into the house, and they closed the door. And the men at the entrance of the house, they struck with blinding light, from the smallest to the biggest, and they could not find the entrance. And the men said to Lot, who else do you have here? Your sons and daughters, sons-in-law, and whomever else you have in the city, take out of this place. For we are about to destroy this place. For the outcry against them has grown great before the Lord, and the Lord has sent us to destroy it. And Lot went out and spoke to his sons-in-law who had married his daughters, and he said, rise, get out of this place, for the Lord is about to destroy the city. But he seemed to his sons-in-law as one that mocked. And as the dawn broke, the messengers urged Lot, saying, rise up, take your wife and your two daughters who remain with you, lest you be wiped out in the punishment of the city. And still he lingered. And the men seized his hand and his wife's hand and the hands of his two daughters in the Lord's mercy upon him and brought him out and left him outside of the city. And when they brought them out, one said, flee for your life. Do not look behind you and do not stay anywhere on the plain. Flee to the high country, lest you be consumed. And Lot said to them, oh no, my lord, behold, now your servant has found favor in your eyes, and you have revealed your great mercy, which you have shown to me in saving my life. But I cannot flee to the high country, lest evil overtake me and I die. Behold, pray, that town there is near enough to escape to. It's such a little place, let me flee there. It's such a little place, then my life will be saved. And he said, I grant you a favor in this matter as well, and I will not annihilate the town which you have spoken of. Hurry, flee there, for I can do nothing until you have arrived there. Therefore is the name of the town called Zoar. The sun had just come out over the earth when Lot arrived at Zoar, and the Lord rained upon Sodom and Gomorrah brimstone and fire from the Lord, from out of the heavens, and he annihilated all those cities and all the plain and all the inhabitants and what grew in the soil. And his wife looked back and became a pillar of salt. And Abraham hastened early in the morning to the place where he had stood in the presence of the Lord. And he looked out over Sodom and Gomorrah and over all the land of the plain, and he saw, and behold, smoke was rising like smoke from a kiln. And it came to pass, when God destroyed the cities of the plain, that God remembered Abraham and sent Lot out from the midst of the destruction. And Lot went up out of Zoar and settled in the high country, and his two daughters with him, for he was afraid to dwell in Zoar. A certain cave he and his two daughters did dwell in. And the older one said to the younger, Our father is old, and there is no man on earth to come to bed with us like the way of all the world. Come, let's give our father wine to drink, and let's lie with him so that we may keep alive the seed from our father. And that night they gave their father wine to drink. And the older one came and lay with her father, and he knew not when she lay down or when she arose. And on the next day the older one said to the younger, Behold, last night I lay with my father. Let's give him wine to drink again tonight, and you go and lie with him, so that we may keep alive seed from our father. And on that night again they gave their father wine to drink, and the younger one arose and lay with him, and he knew not when she lay down or when she arose. And the two daughters of Lot conceived by their father. And the older one bore a son and called his name Moab. He is the father of the Moabites of our days. And the younger one as well bore a son and called his name Ben-Ammi. He is the father of the Ammonites of our days.